blah, 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 blah. Hey, everybody. It's Carlos from Mortals, Inc., and we're here to talk about some Black Library stuff. Joining me, as always, is Mikey.
Black Library time.
Black Library time. Hey, did you ever want to know about the 40K universe?
I mean, I kind of do right now since you're about to explain it to me, I guess.
So Games Workshop produces a game called Warhammer 40K. They also produce Age of Sigmar and a few other games that I'm going to delve into here in the future. But what I want to talk about now is I don't know if it's like a, it's probably a part of their company, but it's called Black Library. And what they do is they produce a lot of books based on the world of Warhammer 40K and Age of Sigmar. And any other game lines. It kind of gives a background to it. Imagine a dark Star Wars. You know, Star Wars is kind of like a upbeat kind of universe of whatnot. Warhammer 40K is like a depressing future of mankind is sprawled across the stars. And in its wake, it just constantly fights with other races to control a lot of the universe. There's really bad people and there's really good people. Sometimes the good people aren't as good as you think they are, but they do what they need to survive.
So just a bunch of gargantuan creatures fighting for the top title. Is it Earth? Does it take place on Earth or just
Earth is
planets?
The center of the universe.
Okay.
As far as humanity is concerned, there's other races, you know, like orcs and Tau and Dark Elder and Elder, and like they're kind of like the classic fantasy races just in space. There's even a version of they're called Tyranids, which kind of look like aliens from the movie Aliens. Yeah, so they kind of come in and try to take what humanity has conquered.
Well, do you remember that background I showed you, that what you're looking at basically behind you? Do you remember what that is, or can you explain what that is, or do you not remember?
This is one of the main characters in the universe. I think it's Phineas Vile, or
he looks like a Phineas.
Yeah, a Vile. I can't remember, but Phineas. He's part of the evil Chaos Gods. He follows the Chaos Gods, and it's like corruption and all that stuff. But there's a whole backstory on what everything is from all their different universes. What Black Library does is it produces a lot of books, and it shows all their backstory. Like, I just read, this didn't just come out, this is an older publication called Maledictions. It's a bunch of short stories, horror stories set in the 40K universe. It uses, in their different universes, it's in 40K and Age of Sigmar. And Age of Sigmar is a fantasy version, but this gives you a good cross-section of the different types of histories and worlds they have, like to help with the gameplay that you play when you play their tabletop games or their board games. This gives you a background to it. It's almost like saying if you were to play Dungeons and Dragons and you would either read or watch Lord of the Rings, this is kind of what these books do for the world, Games Workshop worlds.
Also kind of like makes you a better player when time comes, and it also gives you more knowledge.
Not so much a better player, but it gives a background to it.
So you're more knowledgeable of the situation.
Yeah, knowledge of the background. And a lot of times the background translates over into the rules, but not like anything you could use. Don't think you're going to read this and be an excellent 40K or Age of Sigmar player. It just doesn't work that way. But you'll have a better background. Like when I play 40K, I have Ultramarines, which are like, it's kind of like the what would be considered the perfect Space Marine or the perfect Guardian of Humanity.
Halo Spartans.
Yeah, something like that, I guess. But there's a whole background to that. So you could, I enjoy painting my miniatures. I'm putting them on the table. I enjoy almost the narrative play. So I'm like, all right, these guys would do this. Even if they're going to lose, I lose because I lose a lot. I'm not a very good player. But it doesn't matter because I'm having fun. I'm using the background. Every once in a while, something heroic happens on the table and I'm able to either beat up some guys or outlive the odds against me and make it more heroic. And then that would add to the backstory. It's the same thing with Age of Sigmar. They have a lot of fantasy. They just changed over a few years ago to Age of Sigmar from Warhammer Fantasy. And Age of Sigmar is more of, I'm going to have to read about it more and get the history of it, because they have another full universe. It's like their whole fantasy universe of that. But it's very interesting. But if you ever want to know, and they're just good reads, you don't have to know anything about the universe. Like, this is a short story, and I'll be honest with you, the first story almost made me put the book down because it was a little eh. But the rest of them, they're all good stuff, especially the last story in the book. It's all good stuff. But it makes you say, hey, I want to play that kind of character. Hey, I want to play that kind of army. Or it gives you a background of the universe. Like, why would I want to play this? Like, there's a story in here. Like, I would never play in the Age of Sigmar. They have Sylvan, it's called. It's like tree folk. It's like trees and elves and all. Like, I would never play that in Age of Sigmar because I'm like, why would I play that? But there's a story in here. It kind of gives a background of why they do what they do and how they act. And I'm like, you know, I could play that. You know, I could play that. That sounds pretty for lack of a better word, a badass. I don't know if you can bleep that out, but
I mean, I think it's PG-13 appropriate.
Okay.
PG appropriate, right? You gotta look at the movie guidelines in Hollywood to figure yeah, it out.
That's true. Yeah, it does make it pretty cool. But they do put out good stuff. I've never had, they always have nice books, good covers. Like these are like, see, this is just their standard. It's red, it's horror, it's nicely done. They even put limited editions out, which I never thought I would want. Like I collect books too, you know, I have like classic Dune or Lord of the Rings or, you know, Necromons, you know, anything H.P. Lovecraft. I'll collect books, but I never thought they would put out anything good. But next thing I know, I'm finding buying myself their leather bound, you know, gilded hardback edition of, I think this is called, yeah, see, this is even numbered 49 of 1,000, 490 of 1,000 with a signature in it.
Oh, so that one's author. Special right there.
Yeah, it is. Dark Imperium is what this book is called. I haven't even read it yet. I'm afraid to crack the cover.
Mysterious.
I know.
And it doesn't, disclaimer, it doesn't make you a better player at 40K.
No, it does not make you a better player, but it gives you a background to this.
If you think you're better because you did this, you're not.
And then, prove it. Yeah, I know. And then also they haven't even books for kids. You can have these kids read it. It's good for a great fantasy. It says in the back, a great fantasy adventure that kids will love. These are written. The only thing I could equate it to when I was like 12 or 13, and you'd go to the young adult section of the library. You ever been to a library?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
So you go to that and you'd be like, oh, I want to read a book and you want something high adventure or something cool. These are like these, you know, they still have some illustrations in it and the books are really, you could probably read, you know, a kid could probably read this in a day or two or a couple of days. Like I could probably read this in one sitting, but they have a whole line of these for kids, younger kids. So you and your kids can enjoy stuff too.
Oh, nice. Do the original copies have cuss words in them? Is that why they made that? Or is it just for entertainment purposes?
No, these are all new written stories. So
interesting.
What do you mean? These books? These?
No, the other ones. Do the other ones have cuss words in them?
These are very dark. I would not give these to kids.
Ah, that's why.
The small, yeah. These other ones, like the guy you see behind me, just totally evil. Like there's nothing nice. There's nothing nice in these. The evil guys in the 40K and the Age of Sigmar universes are just out and out. There's not even like, you know, like I equate it to Star Wars. Like they'll tell the plan and say, you can join me or die. No, there's no telling of the, they just kill people.
Yeah, I mean, this dude has a skull in his hand, and then he has a skull staff in his other hand, and then he has syringes poking out the back with skulls on them. I don't know about this.
Yeah, it's a pretty dark universe, but the stories are very dark, but it gives you a definite feel for the game, not the game, but the universe the game is set in, which, honestly, I'll say it again, 40K, the Games Workshop has an extensive, their universe is huge. I would compare it to Star Wars, Star Trek, Lord of the Rings, anything like that. If you're looking for a read or you want to get into the game, stop by, grab a novel, grab a book, look it up. They even have short reads online. You just go to Black Library. I think it's blacklibrary.com.
Yeah, I'll put it in the description. But yeah, just, mortalsinc.com, nevertheless.
Yeah, mortalsinc.com too. And they always come out with every 2 weeks, I see they come out with new novels or books from different backgrounds. So check it out, and I'll start getting these on a regular basis. I think I have some coming back. I had some that were in storage, so I'm going to come and bring them back. They're all still brand new and everything like that. So I'm going to bring them back and give it a try. Remember, mortalsinc.com, support us on Patreon, and subscribe to us on YouTube. Hit the big subscribe button.
Subscribe.
Can I point like this and you'll put a subscribe button there?
Yeah, right there.
If you don't, it's cool. We'll figure that out later.
Peace out.
All right, guys. Later.